An illustrated medical treatise that catches the modern eye more than most is Ulrich Pinder's 1506 Epiphanie Medicorum, a guidebook to the smell, color, and taste of human urine. Hi, my name is Stephanie Stillo, and I'm a curator in the Rare Book and Special Collections Division. In medieval and early modern medicine, analysis of bodily fluids played a key role in prognostic and diagnostic medical practices. For example, monitoring changes in the color of a patient's urine, phlegm, blood, or stool was a non-invasive way to track bodily changes, both for good and for bad. Urine, however, held a particular place of prominence in diagnostic practice. Some physicians went so far as to call urine a divine fluid, a testament to the perceived effectiveness of examining its contents. The wood charts in Ulrich Pinder's Epiphanie Medicorum is a visualization of the practice of uroscopy in early 16th century. The concentric circles that you see here were meant as a quick reference guide. The innermost circle displays a seated physician holding up a vial of urine to the light of an open window, closely examining the fluid for color and particulates. The young man standing near to him, presumably the patient, appears to be explaining his symptoms. The circle that surrounds the physician and the patient is populated with urine flasks and abbreviated captions of different diagnoses. So in this copy, each flask was colored by hand to aid in differentiating possible color tonalities in a patient's urine. Now, the concentric chart worked in collaboration with the table on the following page. So this chart offered even more robust descriptions about the unique colors of problematic urine, and these ranged from clear as well water to red as oriental saffron. The practice of uroscopy was around long before Ulrich Pinder's 1506 Epiphanie Medicorum. Examining urine for color, cloudiness, and particulates dates at least to ancient Greece, when famed physician Hippocrates occasionally employed the method in the prognosis and the predictive outcome of illness. The practice maintained resiliency throughout late antiquity and into the medieval and Renaissance era, eventually finding greater circulation in printed books and pamphlets from the 15th century onward. Much to the dismay of the medical profession, uroscopy eventually became a popular diagnostic method among people with no medical training. In fact, during the 16th and 17th centuries, urine fortune-telling emerged as a profession in Europe, with practitioners claiming that they could divine the future through the color and consistency of urine alone. As one might imagine, the practice garnered harsh critiques from early modern physicians. Despite critiques, the practice of uroscopy continued into the 18th and 19th centuries. For example, here we see a popular uroscopy handbook that circulated in Pennsylvania, Virginia, and Maryland in 1782. Like Pinder, almost 200 years earlier, the handbook offered vivid and creative descriptions of the color of urine, which included categories such as beer-like, flame-colored, and glittering. Also, like Pinder, the 1782 handbook claimed that the color and consistency of urine was diagnostic for everything from delirium and dysentery to gangrene and gout.